Well, Johnny, this is the side of motor racing the fans never see. The hard slog of testing here. Snetterton 2 days. Yesterday, pouring rain. Much nicer day today.
Yeah, fantastic. Ivor Dunbar was in the car with me yesterday. I'd gone in it today. Much nicer weather. Actually quite warm for Snetterton. So yeah, but it's hard work, as you know. This is what it's all about. By the time you get to the race circuit and you're doing well and maybe winning races or standing on the podium, people just think that's what it's all about, but they don't see all the huge effort that goes in behind the scene in the workshops and then coming to the track and trying it right up to the very top. Formula One, World Endurance Championship, the work goes on behind the scenes is just incredible.
Now you're racing here with Richard Dean and Zach Brown's team, United Autosports, and what a setup they've got here for a test.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I was fortunate enough to have a factory tour actually with Richard and Bon the other day, and we had lunch with Zach, and very kind of him to show us around, and fantastic premises. And you can just see now, even at the sort of relatively low level of an LMP3 championship, you can see the professionalism of all the teams here. It's a really nice car. Ligier have done a fantastic job. I mean, it does what it says on the tin. It's aimed at sort of amateur gentleman drivers to progress them up through the ranks. It's very easy to drive in the sense of when you first get in it, it looks incredibly daunting, but once you're in it and drive it, obviously like any car, to get it to the limit is hard. But in terms of driving around sort of second or two off an absolute flat out time, it's actually relatively easy. It's a really nice car, very well put together.
Now you're going to put your two protégés, if we can call Ivor and Bon that, together in a car. You've got quite an interesting programme of races heading towards the winter.
We're going to go to Abu Dhabi, and hopefully Ivor will join us as well in the Gulf 12 Hours with myself and Bon and Ivor in the LMP3 there as well, and have a lot of fun, and hopefully it won't be too hot.
Now Bon's only in his second year, but we've seen here at Snetterton, he's getting on the pace, certainly for a gentleman driver.
He's got feel. I mean, the first moment he drove me around in a challenge car around Brands Hatch Grand Prix circuit on a track day, I could sense that he had a really good feel of the car, and the rest is just experience. In terms of his pace, that's never in question. He just needs to get more and more laps under his belt so he feels really comfortable and nice and consistent and doesn't make mistakes, which is pretty much the same for any driver, whether you're an amateur or a professional.
The Nissan-powered LMP3 car from Ligier is definitely a very sophisticated machine. So let's get Johnny to talk us around the car.
As you can see, very, very different to the other cars that we've seen on the programme, the GT3 488 Ferrari and also the 458 Challenge car of Ivor Dunbar and Bonamy Grimes. So I'll just take you around a little bit to see the differences, although to be quite honest, immediately you see the car, you can see how different it is. Obviously at the front, all carbon fibre monocoque, the splitter, the aerodynamics, very, very different. This car relies a lot more on the downforce element in terms of lap time as opposed to a GT car where there is some aerodynamic downforce, but still nothing compared to this. The most important thing as well is that this weighs about 800 to 900 kilos, a good 300 to 400 kilos lighter than the GT cars. Come back in into the cockpit, pretty standard steering wheel. So you've got the radio button, lights, page to shift through different pages, the neutral button, you have to actually press that before you select the paddle for first gear, otherwise it won't go into first gear, pit lane speed, and then the starter button actually on the steering wheel itself. And then a few other switches in there. Yesterday it was very wet, so we're using the heated shield as well, heated windscreen, and the fog lights. Moving a little bit back, this is the business end of the car. You can actually see you've got the V8 4-litre, puts out probably in the region of about 400 horsepower, fantastic, real low revving but lots of torque, fantastic engine, very, very drivable, and it's incredible actually. This car doesn't have traction control, doesn't have ABS, it's like I said, it's the real baby prototype aimed at the sort of starting format for people wanting to get into prototype racing, which is why it's perfect for Red River Sport and what we're trying to move towards with our road to Le Mans with Bon and Ivor. The biggest difference that you'll see is that the suspension, as opposed to the GT cars where it's bolted onto the actual chassis of the car, you can actually see that the gearbox here and the engine are actually part of the rigid structure of the car with the suspension actually bolted onto it, and that is why you can actually use the car in a lot more in terms of manoeuvring the setups of the car. You don't get different bump steers when you're changing camber or ride height or whatever. It doesn't have an influence on the rest of the setup. So much more like a thoroughbred race car, and not dissimilar to the basic principle behind how single seaters are set up as well. And then you can actually see a little bit here of the rear diffuser. Again, Not a massive rear diffuser. In fact, if you compare it to the 488 GT3 car, not that different, but still gives you a lot of downforce. And round here at Snetterton, going through Riches at turn one or the last corner at Coram, you can really feel the downforce holding the car down. And one of the things that you'll see on the back of the tail here that we were talking about yesterday, you've got this gurney flap here. It's quite a big gurney flap. If you take that off, so you can gain up to 10 kilometers an hour, it's very draggy. Obviously you lose downforce with that as well. So moving forward from that gurney flap, we'll come back to the rear of the car. One of the things that's not unusual to see on a prototype, but you won't see on a GT car, is this spring here, which is actually the third element. And effectively you can control the dynamic ride height of the car using that spring and the gap there. So you can actually get the car to sit slightly higher or lower in terms of the rake of the car when you're going down the straight. So there we have it, the Red River Sport Ligier JSP3.